Hi all, in this video we will see how we can read an OTP using SMS API provided by Twilio to automate the login. So for doing this, I have used my GitHub account where I have enabled the two-factor authentication process. So in two-factor authentication process, once a user enters his username and password, and after clicking on login button, it is the user is redirected to a next page where GitHub asks for a OTP. So the OTP is sent in the registered mobile number of an user. So to use this GitHub two-factor authentication process, first of all, what we have to do, we have to enable two-factor authentication in a GitHub. So let's see how we can do so in the GitHub documents. So they have given a very good document how to enable a two-factor authentication. So configuring two-factor authentication using text messages. So once we login into a GitHub account, we can go to our settings. Under settings, we have a private section where we can go to security. In security, we can look for this particular two-factor authentication section and click on enable two-factor authentication. So once we enable, we get some recovery codes which are needed once which we can use if we do not receive some two-factor authentication codes. So if we do not receive a codes, we can use this for logging into our account. So this is where we'll pass our mobile number, and once we pass our mobile number, it sends an OTP to our mobile number just to authenticate that we are passing our own mobile number. So once we get an OTP and we pass the OTP here and click on enable, so the two-factor authentication gets enabled in our GitHub account. So here what we will be doing, we'll be going directly to Twilio. Here we'll be buying a mobile number, and once we will buy a mobile number, we'll pass that particular mobile number here, we'll register that mobile number in a GitHub, then it will send us an authentication code, and that code will pass into a GitHub and will enable. So in this process, we'll be enabling our new number which we have got from a Twilio to get an OTP from the GitHub. So to get a mobile number, what we have to do, we have to register ourselves into a Twilio. So we can register and go for a trial version of Twilio. It has also enterprise version. So once we get a trial, for this video I am using a trial version. I have also created a mobile number which is +1, so it's from US, it's a toll free number. I have got a mobile number. I have also got a SID as well as secret, the username and the password to use this particular API provided by Twilio for authorization. So I have saved those SID and secret. So we'll be using that for authenticating this SMS API in future. So once we have got an OTP from GitHub, where to find it and how to pass it to the GitHub to enable the authentication. So to look into this, we can directly go here, all product and services. We can click on phone number under super networks, and we'll be redirecting in here, and here it's my registered mobile number. You will be shown your own mobile number. Click here, go to messages logs, go to it under messages log, select incoming messages. So if you are a new user, you will be only shown with a single record where under two column you can find your SMS OTP. As I've used it multiple times, it's showing multiple record over here. So you can pass this particular authentication code in a GitHub for authenticating, and it will enable you the two-factor authentication. So now as we have completed our prerequisite section, so what we have a number from Twilio. We have enabled two-factor authentication in GitHub. We have also verified that we are getting an OTP from a GitHub. Now what the final thing which we are waiting for is to get an SMS API from a Twilio and to automate the complete process. So where to find this SMS API in a Twilio? So let's go back again to a Twilio. Here in a Twilio, if we'll go, so once we are in a Twilio, we can directly look for also here. Sorry. So just click on this option. This is all services, all product and services option. Go to programmable SMS under communication clouds. Under programmable SMS, go to learn and build section. And under learn and build section, look for an API explorer. In API explorer, go into the messages. And here, this is the particular SMS API which I am looking for. So view message list. It's an get method. So what I will do, I will just go and copy this request as a curl, and then I will import the same into my JMeter. So I have copied the curl request. I'll directly go into my JMeter and I'll copy it. So I've copied it. So let's see how it looks. So this is a SMS API coming from Twilio. This is my account number, and that will be a unique for each and every users. If you see in config section, so it has nothing in the header manager. In authorization manager, you can see the username and the password. So the username will be our SID, which we'll get once we are generating while getting a mobile number. And here you will have to pass the secret. So username will be SID and the secret for authenticating that we are a valid users for an Twilio and we want to access this SMS API. So I have done this all these things earlier. I am just disabling this request for now. And so this is how we'll be able to. So let's come back to an JMeter and see how we'll be able to read an OTP using an SMS API. So before explaining anything, I would like to execute this request, and then I would be more it will be more easy for me to explain everything. So I've executed this, getting the response. Oh, red. What happened? So 401. So this is not an error, it's an expected output as we have enabled our two-factor authentication. So we can see that here in a documentation provided by GitHub, that once we enable our two-factor authentications and we'll hit our first request, authorized request, it will gives an 401 unauthorized as an output, and it will ask for an OTP. So this is not a failure, this is an expected result which we were expecting as we have enabled two-factor authentication. So after that, I am calling SMS API from Twilio to get an OTP from a registered mobile number. From here, so I have n number of request, n number of mobile OTP. So from here, I have used a regular expression to extract my OTP, which has been sent from GitHub right now. So what I'm using, I am using a regular expression. I'm using a match number 1 to get the latest as OTP sent by GitHub. So I am passing. So if here, so I have got an OTP from Twilio using this particular SMS API. And if you look into the authorization manager, here I have passed my SID as well as the secret as a username and password for basic authentication that I am a valid user of Twilio. After getting an OTP, I'm again hitting that particular GitHub. I'm hitting a GitHub request, which is a user repository request. So I'm creating an repository into my GitHub account. And for authentication, what I'm using, a GitHub OTP, which has been sent by GitHub, as well as the basic authorization, the username and the password, to validate I'm a valid authorized user to access this particular request. So let's see the output of this particular request. So if you'll see, you can see my login ID name, username and password. So I'm able to log in into my account. So I've got 201 and created. So one repository created. Wow. What next? I have two more requests in my script. So what I'm doing next is I'm hitting a particular authorized token request from a GitHub. So as I have used here a basic authentication where I have passed my username and password as well as OTP for authenticating the users to hit a user repo. I am in my next request, this one, I want to hit it with a token and the OTP. I don't want to pass my username and password in my successive request. So for doing that, I'm getting a token from this particular request. So I'm looking for a token. So I'm hitting this request to get a token. And yes, I'm also good here. You can see I've got a token. Once I hit this request, I have got a token. And again, I'm using a regular expression to extract the token which I have got. And then I'm passing that particular token in this request to authorize. Yes, I'm passing the OTP and the token to authorize that I am a valid user. And again, I'm creating another repository. So what I have done in this video, so first of all, I have explained how to read this SMS API given by Twilio. After that, I have also used the two ways for authentication. I have used a basic authentication as where I have passed my username and password, and I have also used OAuth authorization where I have used token instead of my username and password for authenticating whether I am a valid user or not. So in this way, one can easily automate the complete process of a logging where one needs an OTP to validate whether he is a valid user or not. So I feel I have completed each and everything. I will share all the necessary details in the description. And you can also ask me for any help, and you can comment if you like the video. And thank you.